Good morning from Montrose Old and St Andrew's Church, and welcome to our short thought for the day. There's any amount of game shows and quizzes on television these days. Some have suggested that there are channels who would be in desperate straits without them. They've been around for quite a while, though there's always someone coming up with a new slant. However, Jesus wasn't playing games with his disciples, or expecting the crowds who gathered to hear him to guess who he was. But there were good reasons why, in the early days, he couldn't come straight out and say, "I am the Messiah, the Christ," or "I am the Son of God." Had he done so, he'd have been arrested and probably executed before he ever had the chance of proclaiming the good news of salvation. Instead, he taught him parables, stories that made people reflect and think for themselves. He healed people to an extent that it caused many to link Jesus to God. He lived out a life which bore out his teaching, unlike the hypocrisy to be found in many other teachers. In short, Jesus offered pointers to who he really was. Another way of putting it is that he left space for people to use the faith which they'd been given. Of course, the disciples had the added benefit of being able to ask him lots of questions privately, away from those intent on doing him down. But even they weren't handed everything on a plate. They and we need to open up and trust him. It's not a leap in the dark or blind faith, but it is faith, however small and seemingly weak, that we're to use to begin a journey of trust with and in Jesus. God is well able to grow our faith, which, like muscles, tends to grow through use. Yes, in some ways it would have been easy had God just provided us with a lifetime faith parcel all at once. But he chose to give us his Son as Saviour and invite us to follow the pointers, follow him, exercising what faith we have and promising that he would be with us always, to love us our whole lives through. It is as we step out with Jesus that we learn what faith is. Not so much a lump of spiritual stuff, but the active trust in a Saviour who loves us, that enables us to walk with him through the ups and downs of life and to experience his blessing throughout our lives, indeed into eternity. Thanks for joining us. May the Lord bless you. Amen.